It seems reasonable to believe, going into round three of the Autobacks Japan GT Championship, that it should be Honda's turn at the top. After all, in this most equal of motor racing contests, the NSX has been pretty much overwhelmed so far. And the hilly, windy Sugo circuit is a place that seems well suited to the mid-engined, normally aspirated Honda. For starters, Hondas were first and second quickest in official testing on this northern Japanese circuit, and they go into this race with little or no handicap weight on board. Whereas leading rivals like the Nissans that dominated round two have up to 60 kilos. And the successful Toyotas, like that of reigning champs Joichi Wakasaka and Akira Ida, are toting up to 40 kgs. But the Honda pilots are not optimistic about their title chances and are hurting over an announcement here that the JGTC's Malaysian round is off, a casualty of the SARS threat to travellers. In its place will be an extra Fuji round.
I think now it's finished for us, because this means that nearly 50% of the championship is going to be only on Fuji, and Fuji is a very critical circuit for Honda. So if we are not very, very lucky, I think it's impossible now to finish in the top three in the championship.
One man's pain is another's pleasure. Having another Fuji round suits the Nissan runners.
It's very good for us. We really like Fuji. The Skyline's very strong in Fuji. The engine is strong, and we've always had good results in Fuji, especially last race. We won 2 and 4 finish, so with 2 more races in Fuji, I think we're looking pretty strong for the championship.
Flying Dutchman Tom Coronel is more hopeful about this race than fellow Honda driver Philippe, but only modestly.
Realistically, should be fourth as well, and maybe with a little bit of luck, we could step on the podium.
Yeah, that'd be nice, eh?
Yeah, I think Honda needs it as well, also for the motivation of the team and the motivation of all the Honda people.
Not too surprisingly, given the 60 kgs on their Skyline, modest success is also the go with round two winners Richard Lyons and Masami Kagiyama. No matter that they were third here in testing, they're not even considering a win.
You know, the best thing to do is to finish fourth in every race and you score, like, you know, top points, really.
Yeah.
You know, it's about winning the championship at the end of the day. You know, people only remember a race win for, you know, a few weeks, but a championship, you know, it's always written down. So we're looking at the championship and a few wins just to boost things for Nissan and Nismo and the fans.
Even Benoit Treloya, with the lightest of the three Skylines, isn't confident about winning. Amidst all of this less than confident talk, it's not so surprising that a Toyota tops the timesheets. What is a bit of a shock for the opposition is that it's the Esso Supra that's the pole winner, even with 40 kilos of handicap weight, more than any of the other Toyotas.
I think because of the change in the regulation and any other aspects, I think that although our car's not that perfect yet, the weight's not being so much effective at this point.
So
I think after 10 laps, Motoyama's going to be very fast, but I'd say that it doesn't really matter for Akira to go and, you know, let him go ahead of us, because we're quite sure that we could eventually catch up.
The number 23 Nissan also does the weight-defying thing, qualifying second.
We didn't expect to be in the top three, but we expected to be actually fourth or fifth or sixth in this area. I think that was realistic. I mean, you have to say Satoshi did a fantastic lap there. He banged in that lap that was really, I mean, mega. I mean, I've not seen him drive like this for a long time.
Former champions Yuji Tashikawa and Hironori Takeuchi are third. The Toyota of Eric Comas and Takeshi Tsuchiya is right behind.
For sure, always here, you know, it's a lot of traffic. It's quite hard to pass. And I don't think it will be a huge gap between all the cars. It will be really all packed together.
In GT300, a couple of newcomers threaten to oust the stars of the first two rounds, the Team Taisan Porsches. After all, the series leading GT3R of Shinichi Yamaji and Katsuyuki Nishizawa is weighed down with an 80kg handicap. And the sister car of Atsushi Yogo and Akihiro Asai has 35 kilos on board. That puts the focus on the likes of the Mazda RX-7 that was quickest here in testing. And the Nissan Z car that was next quickest. There's also the Ferrari F360 that was third in testing and missed a good round two finish thanks only to a pit stop problem. There's also a brand new car debuting here, a Toyota Celica by name and by body, but essentially it's a Supra under its badges and bodywork, using the four-cylinder 2-litre motor that the GT500 Supras were using till this season.
Yeah, it's, I think the package is one of the best package in for GT3 handless car, because I think Toyota has a lot of experience for the Supra.
Yeah.
They had many testing, they spent a lot of money for the Supra. I think that car makes really good result, I think.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
Yeah. And some race wins maybe, you think that's possible?
I think definitely we will.
Yeah.
Definitely, yeah.
But it's the Ferrari that claims its first pole position.
For the race, what do you think? Good chance to win?
Yeah, I think after my qualify, Mazda-san try full tank.
Right.
Yeah, full tank is, condition is same. Yeah.
Tanaka just shades the VMAC 320R that's being run this year by the Ban Presto Car Club team.
But last year, this car was built with the Dunlop tires, and we have Yokohama Advan tires this year. So we don't know, we don't really have a clue what's going to happen during the race.
So, but for the season ahead, the car must have a lot of potential, do you think?
Yes,
I think so. We're definitely aiming for champion.
The JGTC has pulled another big crowd here for the Sugo third round of a championship that's so far been a Toyota versus Nissan battle up front. And this time Toyota has the upper hand on the grid with three of the top four places. Wakasaka's 1 minute 17.8 second lap was 1/10 of a second quicker than Motoyama's best in the Nissan. Tashikawa and Tsuchiya were over a quarter second slower. Then came Honda pilots Michigami and Ito, 5 6/10 off pole. Troloya claims 7th and Takuya Kurosawa 8th, still less than a second slower than Wakasaka. In GT300, the Ferrari took pole by 3/100 of a second from the VMAC. The reckless MRS 3rd and the RX-7 were within 3/10 of a second as well. The Garayas 5th and the Honda 6th, still only 6/10 of a second slower than the Ferrari. And then it's the Subaru and the Chrysler Viper. So Akira Ida leads them to the start line with 300 kilometres of this tricky Sugo circuit ahead. Ida in the blue Esso car controlling things nicely in the pole position ahead of Motoyama. The two Toyotas fighting behind for third place. That's Takeuchi in the silver and orange car. Sugiura alongside. Oh, contact there between Dufour and Hiroki Kato. And Kato gets shoved off to the edge of the track. That's going to be very costly for the Honda driver. Started off in ninth place. Oh, and he hasn't got started before the GT300 field arrives. So now he's going to resume way back dead last. What a shame. That is a disaster. So now he'll get started number 42 in the field. Meantime up front, it's come down to a two-car race already with Ida holding off Motoyama and these two getting away from Tsuchiya in third place. But Ida really taking some pressure from the Nissan driver close behind him. Here's the leader in GT300, Hideshi Matsuda, got a bit of a break already on the reckless MRS in second place. And this big fight for third between Ohai and the Mazda RX-7, Tamanaka in the VMAC, and Morio Nitta in the Garaya. Oh, Dominic Schwager in 10th taking pressure from the two Nissans of Troloya and Kageyama. Here's a replay, the VMAC versus the Garaya, and Nitta's going to come off worse. Yes, he turns it around and drops back out of fourth place. Big fight here, this is about sixth place on back. A big line of cars with Kageyama on the tail of it at the moment. Plenty of fights going on, this one between Ohai in the Mazda, and this is Matsuda giving him a hard time in the little MRS and getting past, in fact. Oh, a challenge for the lead. Motoyama really on the back of Ida's car now, trying down the inside. No, that way is closed to him. But boy, the pressure is really coming on now for the lead of this race. Here's Takeshi Tsuchiya's view of things, sitting back in third place in the Wood One Toyota and watching these two go at it, just about 50 metres or so ahead of him. Oh, drama here. This is Dominic Schwager's Toyota has tangled with Sugiyo Matsuda's Honda. They're going to be out of 9th and 10th. Oh, now the third place GT300 VMAC is under attack. Kinoshita comes down the inside in the Nissan, and there's Matsuda and Ohai in the RX-7 also putting the pressure on. The RX-7's got him, I think, and this is happening just in front of the GT500 leaders. They're going to have to be very careful here. Very easy to get caught up in someone else's accident as they loom up on these guys fighting for third place. But it looks like they've got clear through. There's Ida and there's Motoyama safely negotiating the traffic. Further back, Takeuchi fighting off to four, while a big long line of cars, in fact, also having the same problem, having to fight their way through the GT300 traffic. This is for fourth place. Takeuchi under attack from Jeremy Dufour, and Dufour goes down the inside. That's a great start for the Frenchman, up from 11th on the grid to fourth place. Meantime, Hideshi Matsuda doing a good job in GT300 out front of that field. Here's Dufour, the man just moving up. There's the field strung out behind him. Pretty close action in there, that's for sure. And at the tail of it, Naoki Hattori in the number 35 Toyota. Within that group, Kageyama and the Nissan running just ahead of Ito's Honda there. Oh, and up ahead, Sebastian Philippe. He dangles with the GT300 leader. Everyone else manages to avoid him just. And he gets it turned around again and will resume, but he's going to have lost a lot of places. That is one of the constant dangers in the JGTC, the mix of fast GT500 cars and slightly less fast GT300 cars. Here's the Ferrari now. Looks like it's got some damage to the under tray, but still moving pretty quickly. Here's the third place Toyota. Tsuchiya at the wheel of that one, and here comes the race leader. Coming in now to hand over to Juichi Wakasaka. Ida climbs out. Looks like a good stop, and here's the second place Nissan coming in. Motoyama getting out, and the tall figure of Michael Krumm, the German driver, climbing in. And they too get underway, no problem. We're about halfway through the Sugo round, and Masami Kageyama is running fourth at the moment in the Motul Nissan, but only because he has yet to pit stop, whereas most of the race leaders have been in, including the leading GT300 Ferrari sitting there in the pits now. Oh, and there's been a lead change during the pit stop routine. The Nissan of Michael Krumm has got ahead of Wakasaka's number one Esso car, but only just. He's in trouble now, and Wakasaka goes past him again. So the car that led throughout the first half is back where it was. Oh yes, and Krumm does have a problem. Going into that corner, the car looking very loose. Oh, and he steps off the track a little hard, but someone else is right off. Benoit Treloir in the sister car had got up to second because he hadn't yet made his pit stop, but now it's all over. A very, very unhappy Benoit Treloir is out of the race. He was running sixth through most of the first half, so now that's valuable points gone down the drain. Oh, and problems too for the GT300 leader. Just on leaving the pits, the Ferrari must have come to a halt and is being rolled back to the garage. So disasters all round. Well, except for the Tom's Toyota team, that car that was third in the first half has been turned around so quickly in the pits that Eric Comas now leads the race. So it's Comas, Wakasaka and Motoyama. And in GT300, Satoru Goto now leads. This is on board with Wakasaka, looking at Comas. Oh, Comas is held up on some of the lap traffic, and Wakasaka goes around the outside of him. Almost loses it himself, but holds on and has the lead back. That is a fantastic move. So Wakasaka back in the lead of the race in the number one. There's Comas, right tucked on his tail. He'll be looking to try and get that place back. Don't you worry about that. And of course, lots more traffic to be negotiated. Well, I think it works against Comas in this case. So he'd slowed down just a little. But there it is. First and second place is the two Toyotas, and here's the third place Nissan with Michael Krum just a little way back. And Comas on attack again, same situation. Wakasaka held up just a little bit on that Nissan, the 350Z. Oh, but Comas also slowed down. Watching on, Takeshi Tsuchiya, watching his teammate Comas out there. What can he do about it to retake that lead? Things have turned very, very tense, and here comes Comas again, mounting an attack down the front straight, tries down the inside, that doesn't work, pulls outside. Oh, and Wakasaka clashes with Hidetoshi Mitsusada's Honda. Comas gets past. Don't worry about the other car that's dived on through, that Shigekatsu Wakasaka, the brother of the other one, but he is now lapped down, so it's Comas in the lead again, while Wakasaka recovers for second. Here's the onboard view from Comas's car. Wakasaka comes down, locks it up, slams into the Honda. Comas also whams into the back of Wakasaka's car, then suddenly it's Shigekatsu Wakasaka that flashes past both of them. Here's third place Michael Krum. He wasn't close enough to take any advantage out of Wakasaka's big moment. No dramas apparently for GT300 leader Satoru Goto, nor for the second place car, the Mazda RX-7 of Nobuteru Taniguchi, working his way there through some of the lap traffic in GT300. So the Mazda that was running third in the first half doing pretty good. Here's Takeshi Tsuchiya getting interested again, watching his teammates' progress. Oh, he's looking pretty concerned, and that's the reason why, because Wakasaka is right back onto the back of the Wood One Toyota again. So the challenge coming from behind. Once more, Wakasaka throwing down the challenge, trying to get that lead back in this race. They negotiate the lap car. Well, that cost them both, but probably cost Wakasaka more, and Tsuchiya likes that. Here's Goto in the lead of GT300. Oh, the VMAX up the second, as he's about to be put a lap down by fifth place Richard Lyons. But this is it, the last few corners of the race. Comas in the lead, but only just. Defending champion Wakasaka just looking for the slightest opportunity to get on past here in the closing seconds of this race. Right behind him now as they come to the last corner. Wakasaka a little wide. Now comes down the inside, trying through all this contact. Oh, he squeezes Comas off the edge of the track. He's got it. Tsuchiya cannot believe his eyes. Coming down to the checkered flag, Wakasaka's got it. Oh, Comas dives at him again. I think there was contact right on the finish line. What a way to finish a 300k race. Just a millisecond in at the finish line, but Wakasaka has done it. The Toms team discusses the disappointment of the last few seconds of the race. Comas, there he is, head down on the wheel. He's utterly gutted at how it's turned out. Here comes Satoru Goto, tracking Tom Coronel to the finish line to take the GT300 victory. A good win by the Toyota team, just 3 seconds ahead at the end of the VMAC. Wakasaka climbs out of the car to big hugs from Ida. What a fantastic finish to the race that was. So much drama through the last half of it, that's for sure, after a very straightforward first half. And for Comas, dejection. Imagine how he feels.
Like, because the number 81 car was very slowing down, and Eric got caught in that car and it got drifted and his tail went sliding. And so the inside was open, so that's when I went in. I was much understeered also as much as he is, so it was just like one chance in a million. I think the whole situation was quite clean, and I mean, nobody has anything against each other, and it just happens to be that I was just luckier.
Well, big disappointment, of course. The win was in my hands. First when we pit out, and then I got oil on the track, which I had no indication that was inside, and I chose the inside line, so I really screwed the tires first. And then the number one passed, and I had to push really 100% on the tire, which I didn't want it to do. I wanted to save the tire for the last 20 laps, which I could not afford, because I pushed so much on the tire that they gone by the end, and so that's what happened. Last corner, I was really struggling to keep the car in line, and it just went out inside, and yeah, just lead until last 200 meters, too bad.
Congratulations, well
yes.
Done.
Yes, we got it! Got it!
So first the other cars were ahead of us, but we made sure that they wouldn't give us too much gap, and we held on to the end. I think that worked out very well.
No. Yeah, 全然 enjoy どころじゃないです。
I think it was a bit my fault, but the car eventually lost balance, and I think I used up all the margin the quota has already gained for me. So I'm very, very happy to win, and very, very happy. I'm really relieved.
Well, a friendly shove there from Takeshi Tsuchiya against Wakasaka, the man who took the win away from Eric Comas, his teammate, looking very dejected there up on the podium. Comas, not a smile to be had, very grim-faced. There's the Nissan team that did come in third, Michael Krum and Satoshi Motoyama. So a dramatic finale to this 300k race here at Sugo today, with Juichi Wakasaka and Akira Ida taking the win out by just a split second over Takeshi Tsuchiya and Eric Comas. Satoshi Motoyama and Michael Krum come home third in their Nissan ahead of Seiji Ehara and Jeremy Dufour. Then it's Masami Kageyama and Richard Lyons fifth. In GT 300, the happy Sasaki and Goto end up just 2.9 seconds ahead of the Tamanaka and Gomafune VMAC at the checkered flag. Taniguchi and Ohai salvage third in their RX-7 ahead of Nitta and Takagi in the Garaya and the Honda NSX. In the championship, the win puts Wakasaka and Ida back into the lead by just 2 points from Motoyama and Krum. Lyons and Kageyama drop to third, while Comas and Tsuchiya move up to fourth. Similarly, in GT 300, Sasaki and Goto's victory moves them into a 2-point lead over the Yamaji Nishizawa Porsche pairing. Kinoshita and Yanagita are third in the Nissan Z car, ahead of Nitta and Takagi and Asai and Yogo.